Hey there, I'm Benjamin from Loves Data. In this video, you'll learn the 9 biggest AdWords mistakes that you need to avoid when managing your account. By avoiding these common mistakes, you'll be ahead of the competition. You'll be rocking AdWords in no time. And even if you don't have time to apply all of the tips to your own campaigns today, even a small change can have a positive impact on the performance of your account. Let's jump in and cover the 9 biggest AdWords mistakes. Mistake number one is not using keyword match types. There are 5 main keyword match types that you need to be aware of. These are broad match, broad match modified, phrase match, exact match, and negative match. If you're just using broad match keywords, then your ads will appear on a wide range of keywords, which means you'll need lots of negative keywords to ensure your ads appear for the most relevant terms. Here's a comparison of the different match types that can trigger your ads. You can see as you move from broad match to using broad match modifiers, you'll reduce the number of impressions of your ads. And as you move to phrase and exact match, you become even more precise. Exact match keywords can be useful for focusing in on your most important keywords, but they also come with limited search volume. So you'll need to balance the keyword match types you use in your ad groups. Mistake number two is being too shy with negative keywords. Adding lots of negative keywords won't hurt the performance of your campaigns. In fact, it will help you achieve higher click-through rates and your ads will be more relevant as people are searching. If you find that you're adding the same negative keyword to more than one campaign, then create a negative keyword list in the shared library. This will allow you to manage a single list of negative keywords that are applied to multiple campaigns. Mistake number three is skipping the use of branded keywords. I've found that bidding on your own branded terms is the cheapest traffic you can acquire from AdWords, but it's not just about cost. It's also about visibility and conversions. Having a paid ad along with your organic listing on search results will lead to more clicks. Google and Bing have both done studies on incremental clicks and found that running ads on branded terms will increase your traffic. And since you get to control the message and the landing page, you'll also see higher conversion rates. Mistake number four is only having one ad variation per ad group. You always want to be testing new things, and this includes your ad variations. If you only have one ad in each of your ad groups, you're likely to be missing out. You absolutely want to be testing your ads. Having two ads within each of your ad groups allows you to test different calls to action and messaging to see what works and what doesn't work. Here are 5 things that you can start testing in your ads now. Include location-specific details, test different calls to action, include credentials and awards, try different selling points, including prices and promotions, and try testing changes to punctuation and capitalization. You should always be testing. Mistake number 5 is not considering the relationship. It's important to consider all these elements, the keyword, the ad, and the landing page. The better the relationship between these elements, the better the performance of your campaigns. It's simple, it's logical, but it's often overlooked, and not just by beginners. Mistake number 6 is incorrect geographic targeting. When it comes to setting your geographic target, I recommend using the data you currently have at hand to help you decide. If you can find the locations where you're currently receiving conversions, then start with those before expanding your reach. Some people immediately feel that their product or service will succeed with a global audience, even though they're only currently converting very localized customers. This simply isn't the case with AdWords. I've found that when people insist on starting with a larger geographic target that includes areas where they don't have any existing business, they tend to fail. Start with the locations where you're currently winning. You can always expand later. Mistake number 7 is poor landing page experience. If you're really serious about getting the most out of your campaigns, then you really need to start with your landing pages. You need to think about where people land and then work from there. And if you don't have a suitable landing page, you might want to reconsider launching that new campaign. Rather than investing in something that won't work, spend time fixing your landing pages or at least setting up some quick optimization tests before you launch your campaign. Mistake number 8 is not using the search terms report. Because of the keyword match types, there's a difference between the keyword you're bidding on and the search term that someone enters when they're on Google. The search term report allows you to see what people are searching for. Review these search terms. You'll find the report within the Keywords tab. Just click on Search Terms. you should spend time here on a regular basis reviewing the search queries and deciding if they're good, in which case you should add them to an ad group. If they're not good, then you'll want to add them as a negative keyword. Mistake number 9 is missing conversions. I don't see this as often as the other common AdWords mistakes, but it does pop up from time to time. Make sure you take the time to track conversions. You should have conversion tracking set up before you launch your campaign. So they're the 9 biggest AdWords mistakes that you need to avoid. And the great thing with AdWords is that once you start optimizing your campaigns, you'll quickly see the improvement. Even spending one day a month checking and improving your campaigns using these tips will have an impact. Remember, the key to success with AdWords is to consider the relationship between the 3 critical elements: the keyword you're targeting, the ad that you're displaying, and the landing page that you're sending people to. The better the relationship, the better the performance of your campaigns. So what's stopping you? Load up your account and put a big tick next to each of these common pitfalls and rock your account. You can and will succeed at getting the clicks and conversions you're aiming for. Do you have any tips you'd like to add? Let me know in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, then please like it so I know to make more videos like this. See you next time.